Yes, hello and a wonderful evening here for day 9, the last day of the league matches of the Platinum Corporation Superstar League powered by Global T20 Canada. And the first match, Bombay Blasters versus Avacules. May I first call upon the skipper of Bombay Blasters, Prateek, if I may have you first here. Yes, Prateek, a close day today, very important day for you. You've almost qualified. Still, what is important for you is to register a victory today.
Yes, we need to win. We actually want to come second on the points table. So we have two chances at the final. But let's see, Avacules is also a great team. They've beat Yuva as well as Nivan. And they've lost to the superstar team. So they're a dicey team. You don't know how they're going to perform. But I'm sure they are prepared for this game. And we are as well.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. All the very best today. May I please call upon the skipper of Avacules? Yes, Darshan. Please join us for the coin toss. Yes, Darshan, extremely important day. Two matches, you have to win them and with a convincing margin.
Yeah, I think margin's not the priority right now. We just take it game by game and try and win both the games. Because I think if the momentum keeps going, we should be able to cover it up.
Wonderful. All the very best for the matches. So it's time for the flipping. Who will go ahead with the coin? Yes, Darshan. Darshan will flip. Yes, so Prateek will call either Platinum Corp or Superstar. You know the drill. Platinum is the call. It's a long shot there. And Platinum it is. Okay, so Platinum it is. Bombay Blasters have won the toss.
We'll bat first.
Bombay Blasters have elected to bat first.
स्विच कर
Yes, it's the last day of the league table, the league matches, the last day, it's day 9, tomorrow we'll have playoffs, and as the rules go, the playoffs will be having 4 matches, it'll be qualifier 1, which will be a match between team 1 and team 2 on the points table. The team which wins the first qualifier directly enters the final. The team which loses the first qualifier has yet another chance to play in the second qualifier, wherein they'll be playing against the winner of the eliminator. Eliminator will be played between, on the table, team 3 and team 4. The team which loses will be out. The team which wins will enter the second qualifier. Second qualifier will be loser of the first qualifier and winner of the eliminator. And eventually the winner will enter the finals to face the winner of the first qualifier. So that's the playoffs that is generally followed in all league formats. And there's another rule that we have added. The Superstar League has added another yet exciting rule on the playoffs. That is, if one woman player is missing, it will result in minus 30. So minus 30 will be the penalty for the team which has one woman player less. And in the first over, if a wicket is lost of a woman batsman, that's a batswoman, it'll result in minus 10. So minus 10 for a wicket on the first over of a batswoman, and the absence of a woman player, will result in minus 30. So we're coming down to the last two exciting days. One team has qualified, three teams are eyeing for the remaining three positions. In a few minutes, we'll be starting with the first match, Avakulis versus the Bombay Blasters. Yes, sir. We are generally in a very ecstatic mood at the Superstar League, but not the same today. It was not a very good day for India yesterday. We had one of the most disastrous attacks at Pulwama district in Jammu and Kashmir when we had 40 CRPF jawans who were martyred. So all that we can do at the Superstar League is offer our respect to the martyrs and condolences to the family members with a 2 minutes silence for them. Yes. Thank you so much. May go ahead with the game. Thank you so much. Yes, good evening and welcome. Welcome to day 9 of the Platinum Copperzen Superstar League powered by Global T20 Canada. It's the last day of the league stages and it's 4 important matches which will tell us who are the 4 teams qualifying for the playoffs. One team which is confirmed and qualified for the playoffs is Nivan Royals, and then it's a competition between the Bombay Blasters, Avakulis, UR Strikers and of course Team B. The first match, Bombay Blasters versus Avakulis. Bombay Blasters are sitting third on the points table with 10 points and Avakulis 6 points. However, Avakulis have 2 matches for the day lined up. So, brilliant opportunity for them to make the most of it. Bombay Blasters are third on the points table. Comfortable, good run rate as well. All they need to do is register a victory to confirm their position in the playoffs of the Season 1 of the Superstar League. Few minutes back, we had the toss. Then the Bombay Blasters had won the toss and they have elected to bat first. They said we'll put a target on board and we'll let Avakulis chase it down. There we go with the countdown. We're about to start match 1, day 9. Bombay Blasters versus Avakulis. It's going to be an all-women start. The two openers, the batswomen, Reshma Rochlani and Mansi Scott, the two openers. And Bombay Blasters owned by Prateek Jadhwani and Hitesh Rohira. Ava Kuli is owned by Abhinav Shukla, Darshan Godawat and Parth Pawar. There's only one team which we can consider as a confirmed qualification into the playoffs, and that is Nivan Royals, owned by Nikhil Mansukhani. And the last pot is still to grab. Yes, it's going to be Minisha Lamba bowling round the wicket to Reshma Rochlani. It's going to be an all-women start on day 9 of the Superstar League. Bowling round the wicket is Minisha Lamba. Reshma on strike outside the off stump, and a white ball is a signal. So the first runs of the day coming through extras. Minisha Lamba bowling it outside the off stump, and that's the first run on the board for the Bombay Blasters. On the leg side, played the square leg fielder. Looks like it'll be a single. Going for the second run. Yes, good running between the wickets there. So two runs they've taken, so three on the board. Manisha countering round the wicket. Reshma Rochlani still keeping strike. Outside the off stump, in the air, opening the face of the bat. Hits the A-board, so the ball is in play. And two runs taken, going for the third. And yes, that's good running between the wickets. Waiting for umpire's confirmation. Yes, so dead ball signal perhaps after three runs taken. Three runs registered. Okay, so three runs registered. So it... Yes, it's six runs on the board. An extra as well. So we might be counting three runs, waiting for the confirmation from the umpires. A powerful batting lineup is the Bombay Blasters. Of the highest run getters are from the team Bombay Blasters. They had a massive victory last week when they defeated Mumbai Game Changers. So the Bombay Blasters definitely in some form. Yes, it's day 9, four matches for the day. The first match, Bombay Blasters versus Ava Kuli, and it's Mansi Scott on strike, and she'll be facing Manisha Lamba. Manisha Lamba bowling round the wicket to Mansi Scott on the leg side, in the air, straight to the fielder, long on, going for the second run, and yes, good running between the wickets. Two runs taken. So good start for the Bombay Blasters. Eight runs scored off just the first three deliveries, and that's the end of the first spell for Minisha Lamba. She'll be back bowling the last three series of the innings. That's the rule in the Superstar League. We have an all-women start. Mansi Scott and Reshma Rochlani, the openers for the Bombay Blasters. Laksh Kochar, the new bowler, be bowling to Mansi Scott. Mansi batting on two. Bowling round the wicket is Laksh Kochar. Flighted delivery outside the off stump, in the air, straight to the fielder at long on. And going for the second run. Yes, good running between the wickets by Reshma and Mansi. Two runs taken. So that's been quite a decent start for the Bombay. One run short, says umpire Kotian. So it's going to be a run short. So it's nine runs. Two runs taken, one run short. Mansi and Reshma will have to be careful. It's a run short signaled. So four deliveries, nine runs on the board. On the back foot, player on the leg side. A preferred area for the batswoman. Yes, it's Reshma and Mansi, the openers for the Bombay Blasters. And it was the Bombay Blasters themselves who won the toss and they decided to bat first. So it's Mansi Scott on strike. Laksh Kochar to continue around the wicket. Farhan ensuring that the field is set right. The first over is not the power play. The second over will be the mandatory bowling power play. That's when the field restrictions will be imposed. So dot ball, the last over of the last delivery of the first over. Good work at the mid-wicket fielder by Manish Alamba. Two runs to end the first over. Bombay Blasters are 11 for no loss. Yes, it's a current run rate of 11 for the Bombay Blasters. The last delivery, two runs were registered. So it's Mansi Scott and Reshma Rochlani who have got a good start for the Bombay Blasters. They're 11 for no loss at the end of the first over. And it's a must-win contest for Avakulis. They'll have to win this match. And if they do win this match, they'll also have to repeat the performance in the last match of the day when they'll be playing against Team B. Second over will be the bowling power play. Field restrictions will be imposed. Vishal Singh to bowl the all-important over. The bowling power play over. Bowling round the wicket, it seems. And it's Reshma Rochlani on strike. That's been the policy outside the off stump. Well left by Reshma. That's a dot ball. Vishal continuing round the wicket. Outside the off stump, play on the leg side. Straight to Farhan. And going for the second run. The umpire says that's where we have to stop play. So that's one run registered. 12 on the board for Avakulis. 1.2 overs, 12. Both batswomen have faced four deliveries each. Straight and yes. So Mansi has been run out. Good innings by Mansi. Sacrificing her wicket for the team's cause. Scoring 5 runs. And that's the first wicket for Avakulis. And Mansi Scott walks back to the dugout. She scored 5 from 5. And the new man in is Raja Sonthalia. The big hitter of the tennis ball is Raja. Is the next man coming in. Played on the leg side. Straight to the fielder. Darshan Godawat there. That'll just be a single. So Reshma moves on to 7 of 5 deliveries. Raja Sonthalia facing his first delivery. Vishal Singh bowling around the wicket. Field restrictions imposed. Yorker delivery, bottom edge, straight to the wicket keeper. Dot ball. So good over by Vishal so far, conceding only 2 runs. One over, it was 11. In the air, a thick edge. The ball will turn for sure. And a chance for a run out, is it? Waiting for the signal from the umpire. And out is the signal, is it? Yes, out is the signal. So that's the second wicket. At the end of 2 overs, Bombay Blasters 13 for the loss of 2 wickets. Vedant Malik and Raja Sonthalia. Two power hitters for Bombay Blasters at the crease now at the end of 2 overs. They have 6 overs to capitalize now. 13 for 2. It was the Bombay Blasters who won the toss, decided to bat first. And at the end of 2 overs, they are 13 for the loss of 2 wickets. Both the batswomen are back in the dugout. So it's Raja Sonthalia and Vedant Malik. It'll be Raja on strike and Hem Shah bowling around the wicket to Raja. It's a thick edge and that's a wicket. It's an RSB wellness catch. Wonderfully held by Abhinav Shukla at the covers region. No mistake whatsoever. It can become difficult at times. It's a thick edge. So the ball turns to swirl in the air. And the tennis ball, it becomes difficult with the sun in his eye. Wonderfully held in the end-to-end by Abhinav Shukla. And that's the third wicket. That's the third wicket of Bombay Blasters. Yes, so it's Siddhant who gets off the mark. New man in is Siddhant. And it's 3 wickets lost. Raja Sonthalia, an important wicket for Avakulis. Avakulis will be mighty pleased by looking at Raj heading back to the dugout. Vedant on strike, Hemshah continuing round the wicket. On the leg side, straight to Darshan, won't make a mistake there, that'll just be a single. So Bombay Blasters will just have to consolidate the innings now. Three kick wickets. And Raja Sonthalia is back in the dugout. Hemshah continuing round the wicket to Siddhant Oberoi in the air. And that's a Platinum Corp 6. So that's the first 6 of the day. And the first 6 of the innings for the Bombay Blasters. Hemshah continuing round the wicket to Siddhant Oberoi. Similar result. Over the long one boundary, Platinum Corp 6. Yes, the last delivery of the third over. Full toss. Once again over the long one boundary. Platinum Corp 6 to end the third over. Bombay Blasters are 33 for 3. So number 4, it's time for the Global T20 Canada double trouble over. Number of runs scored will be doubled, wicket lost will be minus 5. Siddhant Oberoi and Vedant Malik, the two men at the crease. It's going to be Sunny Raj Sawan bowling round the wicket to Vedant Malik. Comes down the track. And was to the fielder, wonderful attempt. And it'll just be a single there, wonderful attempt. Wonderful work in the field by our QLEs. They're all pumped up. They know what an important match this is for our QLEs. They will have to win the match in order to stay in the competition. Siddhant, the man on strike. Sunny Raj Chawan, the bowler, full toss. What a long one boundary, Platinum Corp 6. Sunny bowling on the wicket, on the leg side, straight to the fielder at long on, just a single. Sunny continuing, Vedant Malik on strike, has scored 2 runs of 2 deliveries. He's known for his big hits over the boundary. Straight to the fielder once again, at the long on boundary, just a single. So it's a moderate start for Vedant. We haven't seen a lot of singles from Vedant in the Superstar League, but as of now, he scored 3 of only 3 deliveries. So it's Siddhant back on strike, batting on 26. And that's a chance for Sunny. He's a brilliant outfielder, but the reflex catch just creating some trouble for Sunny. Just not able to latch on to it. So that definitely will be considered as a missed opportunity by Sunny himself. He sets high standards for himself in the field. Last delivery and it's straight to the fielder and that's an RSB wellness catch. Vedant Malik not in the bestest of form today. Will have to walk back. And it's minus 5 on the board now for Bombay Blasters. Vedant is unhappy. And it's a rare failure for Vedant. He'll have to walk back. At the end of 4 overs, Bombay Blasters are 48 for 4. Four overs, 48 for 4 are the Bombay Blasters. Tanuj Virwani, the new man in. Siddhant on strike, batting on 27. Four overs, 48 for 4. Outside off stump, in the air. Will that be a chance? It is! Oh no, they have dropped it. So it was a clash between the fielders. It was straight to the man, but you have to call there. That's what we learn in the first stages of cricket. We have to call when the ball is in the air. But that's a single for Siddhant. Tanuj is on strike. Yes, well played there. Tanuj just defending it on that occasion. Not taking any risks whatsoever. They need to get at least 100 runs on the board. Tanuj on the back foot in the air. That's a thick edge. Sadirat Sawan under it. And it's an RSB wellness catch taken. Tanuj Virwani will have to walk back. That's wicket number 5 for our Aquiles. They are pumped up. And that's a rare batting failure for the Bombay Blasters. They are a powerful batting lineup. And they have lost 5 wickets in the 5th over. 49 for 5, the Bombay Blasters. Marudhar Shekhawat, the bowler. Tanuj Virwani, the last wicket. 49 for 5 are Bombay Blasters. So, Aquiles will be mighty pleased by the effort so far. Ishan Verma, the new man, on strike, in the air, on the leg side. And that's an RSB wellness catch. Wicket number 6. Yes, it's been a massive batting failure for the Bombay Blasters. Back-to-back wickets there. Ishan Verma. It was Sushant Oberoi on this occasion. And it's a review taken, is it? Yes, it's a review taken by the Bombay Blasters. And it's a review taken for ball hitting the overhead wires. And on-field decision is it is a wicket. So we need conclusive evidence to overturn the decision. We'll have to overturn the on-ground decision. We need conclusive evidence. So we have the best camera angles. Every team has 2 unsuccessful reviews. And yes, it seems it'll be the on-field decision that stays. And it's a wicket. So it's the first review lost by the Bombay Blasters, and it is a half team collapse as of now for the Bombay Blasters. Very rare, we haven't seen that happening for the Bombay Blasters. But 2 back-to-back wickets for Marudhar Shekhawat. Down the leg side, wide ball signaled. So it's 50 on the board for the Bombay Blasters. They've lost 6 wickets. Onto the leg side, straight to Darshan Godawat, just a single. That's what Ishan and Sharan will have to do. They have to consolidate the innings. 6 wickets lost. On the leg side, Ishan Verma, the batsman, hits the A board. It's the ball is in play, so it'll be 2 runs. Yes, it's 2 runs added to the scorecard. Are Bombay Blasters. 5 overs, 53 for 6, and it's been quite a moderate start for the Bombay Blasters. Losing 6 wickets in the 5th over is not something that you're used to seeing in the Superstar League for the Bombay Blasters, but Aquiles be mighty pleased. They need to win this match with a big margin for them to stay in the competition. Abhinav Shukla, the new bowler. In the air, and it's an RSB wellness catch. Sadirat Sawan making no mistake there. Sharan Prem, 7th wicket of the Bombay Blasters. 53 for 7 now. Yes, so that's these words that we use in cricket. It's a mighty batting collapse of one of the most powerful batting units in the Superstar League. Bombay Blasters are 53 for the loss of 7 wickets. Aquiles, wonderful work by team Aquiles in the field. Abhinav Shukla bowling now. Mihir Desai, the next man in. No ball signaled. Yes, Abhinav will be unhappy with his effort. So it's a no ball and a run. So it's going to be a free hit. Yes, umpire Kotian signals it's a free hit. Ishan Verma comes down the track on the leg side, straight to Darshan. That'll just be a single. So Ishan not able to capitalize on the free hit. Abhinav continuing over the wicket. Mihir Desai, the man on strike. In the air, straight to Sanirat Sawan. Brilliant work by him in the field. That's a direct hit. Brilliant work by Sunny. And on-field decision by umpire Kotian. It's not out. So that's just going to be a single. That's what Ishan and Mihir need to do. They need to rotate strike. Get those ones and twos. 57 for 7. In the air, on the offside. Fielder under it. It's an RSB wellness catch. Wicket number 8, Ishan Verma will have to walk back. Abhinav Shukla is on a roll. Second wicket for him in the over. 5.4 overs, 57 for 8 now at the Bombay Blasters. Yes, it's been a mighty collapse. I'm using these words again and again because it's quite an unreal sight here at the Superstar League at Astro Park in Bandra West, wherein Bombay Blasters are 8 wickets down for 57. They have been a powerful batting lineup throughout the tournament. And all that Gaurav Gala and Mihir Desai need to do now is... And that's a direct hit. Wonderful work by the wicketkeeper. And that's a wicket. Wonderful work by Hem Shah. And that's a wicket, is it? We're waiting for confirmation. And Gaurav Gala was the man. They've taken a review. It was a no ball, so it's going to be a free hit to follow. Yes, and that's the wicket. Yes. So it's a soft dismissal that we say. It was a white ball. It was a no ball. So no ball precedes the white ball signal. It was not collected by Hem Shah behind the stumps. The batsman went for the run. Hem Shah quickly gathered the ball, a direct hit, and the ninth wicket lost. So it's Karan Rotslani, the new man in on the leg side. Straight to Manisha Lamba. Brilliant work by Manisha at the square leg region. Just a single. Karan gets off the mark. 59 for 9 in 5.5 overs at the Bombay Blasters. On the leg side, a thick edge. Straight to the fielder's chance for a run out. No, not to happen. A single to end the sixth over. Bombay Blasters are 60 for 9. Wonderful spell by Abhinav Shukla. The over that is bowled picked up 2 wickets and conceded only 7 runs. Yes, over number 7 will be the batting power play. The batting team has a choice of getting their power play from over number 4 to over number 7, and if not taken, over number 7 by default becomes the batting power play. Field restrictions to be imposed. Mihir Desai on strike. Farhan Khan the bowler. It's a straight delivery that's missed the stumps. Mihir Desai going for the leg side boundary, not making connection, and that's missed the stumps by inches. Is the last wicket for Bombay Blasters. Straight to the fielder, Sanirat Sawan, and just not able to hold on to it, was he? So that's definitely not a catch. We are waiting for signal from the umpire, and that's just a run taken. So good work by Sunny. But as I've said, he's set high standards for himself. So he'll consider it as a drop catch, a single. On the leg side, plays Karan. Straight to Darshan Godawat. Brilliant work by Darshan in the field. Just a single. 62 for 9, 6.3 overs. Farhan bowling to Mihir. Full toss. A thick edge. It has hit the stumps. However, it can be a wicket only if the bails have been dislodged. Not happening on this occasion. 6.4 overs, 62 for 9, the Bombay Blasters. Yes, Mihir just making a change in the bats. Wants to clear the fence. Farhan Khan, wonderful bowling by him so far. 4 deliveries, only 2 runs conceded. He'll be looking for a wicket. On the back foot, straight to Sunny there on the one bounce, and that'll just be a single. 63, the score moves on to. 6.5 over 63. Farhan bowling to Karan. Karan on the back foot, in the air. Could be a chance for a catch. And it is a wonderful RSP catch. Well, let's take in... For the innings to end for the Bombay Blasters in the end of 7 overs. Bombay Blasters 63 all out. It's a very rare opportunity wherein I also say it's a team that is all out. 7 overs, Bombay Blasters all out. It's a wonderful RSB wellness catch taken. And 64 is the target for Avakulis. Yes, wonderful work by Avakulis. They had to win this match with a big margin. And it's a wonderful start. So Mansi has got Siddhant Oberoi scoring 28. The only worth mentioning, 7 overs, 63 all out. are the Bombay Blasters. Wonderful work by our QLs in the field. Brilliant catching, brilliant bowling. So that's a quick summary at the end of the first innings. It was Bombay Blasters won the toss. They elected to bat first. And at the end of their innings, 7 overs, 63 all out. Ava Kuli is our target of 67.
Let's play. Right, we're all set for the second innings of what could be a one-sided game, but one can't really point fingers in cricket. It's a team effort. Everything that you see on the field, all the results that end up later on the scoreboard, on the summary card, is a team effort. Manisha Lamba and Neha will open up for Team Evacules. Only 64 runs to chase. They can make quick work of this. Here we go again, the second delivery coming up. Just a single run of the first ball was considered, and this one is going to be an extra coming in for Team Evacules. The Bombay Blasters cannot afford to give away runs like that. Oh, and that's going to be a no ball. Extras coming in the first over itself. Pressure clearly showing its side effects on the team in red. The Bombay Blasters, they have done phenomenally throughout the tournament. Evacules are still not in the top four. They've played two games less and they have 6 points to themselves. They need to win this one. Well, that was far down the offside. It could have been a white ball again, but the ball played down the ground. And yes, it's just one run. That's it. go for no loss is what the scoreboard reads at the moment. Oh yes, that's far away down the off leg side. It's a white ball. Rishma trying to get a grip of it. It's going to be a white ball again, and a lot of pressure mounting on the female bowler who's opening the innings for the Bombay Blasters. She has to bowl one more legal delivery in order to wrap things up. That's another white ball. Just has to calm down a bit. That is a beautiful camera work by our media team. They're doing a fantastic job. Our broadcast partner, tenniscricket.in, our internet partner, 7-Star Cable. And of course, this event is managed by Star Connect Entertainment, doing a fabulous job on the coverage of this elite underarm cricket league, Platinum Corp Superstar League. We're almost down to the second last day of this beautiful tournament. Platinum Corp presents Superstar League, powered by Global T20 Canada, is Mumbai's newest and one-of-a-kind elite underarm turf cricket league. This league is a unique collaboration of sports, celebrities and entertainment, conceptualized by Mr. Dino Moria, Mr. Surat Samat, Mr. Danish Ingora, Mr. Muhammad Ali and Mr. Samir Khan. We go by the hashtag networking through cricket. Right now, this is day 9 of the Superstar League, the last day of all the league matches. Tomorrow is going to be the 10th day of this one-of-a-kind tournament. The finals, the playoffs, all the excitement is going to be collected in here at the AstroTurf Park in Bandra. 7 runs on the scoreboard. Rishma still struggling to bowl that last legal delivery of hers. That's going to be wide again. Eight runs on the scoreboard already of just 2 balls. And yes, this time Rishma makes no mistake. And she bowls that final legal ball of hers. And there's a run out on the non-striker's end. And yes, that is the first wicket. The fielding side not too enthusiastic about that wicket. They know that they have a lot of work to do. They have to defend 56 runs in 46 balls. And it is a Herculean task to do so, especially in the format of turf cricket. The score at the end of 3 balls is 9-1. The required run rate is 7.33. Manisha on strike. It's going to be a dead ball. Oh, and that's a clean bowl there by Mihir. Manisha will return after scoring 2 runs. Team of Achilles still off to a good start. They've still got 1 more ball to spare in the first over. The score is 9-2. Another wicket could boost the morale of the Bombay Blasters. Playing it smart, going for that single so that Sunny can keep strike in the second over. First over gone. Team of Achilles have scored 10 runs and they've lost 2 wickets while they were at it. The required run rate is 7.771. Team of Achilles on the right track over here. This is a very important game for Team of Achilles. They've only got 2 games left in the Superstar League. Bombay Blasters, however, are playing their last game. The Bombay Blasters have lost 2 games so far in the tournament. Nevan Royals are the only team who have only lost 1 game in the entire tournament. With the 12 points, they are dominating the points table. They are table top at the moment. UA Strikers with 10 points are on the second spot. The Bombay Blasters are on the third spot. And the Game Changers, who are done with their quota, are on the fourth spot. However, Achilles can steal the fourth spot away from Team Mumbai Game Changers if they manage to win this game. Team of Achilles, they still have 2 more games to go. They're playing their second last game as we speak. They have 6 points for themselves on the score, on the points table. Fantastic catch there in the deep. But looks like there's a no ball that has been signaled by the umpire. That's lucky for Team of Achilles. They already have an upper hand in terms of required net run rate. And now they have been granted another opportunity to bat. Lovely fielding there in the deep by Vedant. He's a fantastic cricketer. Everything produced out of his caliber has allowed the Bombay Blasters to do so well in the tournament. So a strong shot there, but just ones and twos coming in. Haven't seen a boundary so far in the second innings. 14 runs on the scoreboard. 50 required now in 39. It's going to be a white ball. A lot of extras pouring in for Team of Achilles. Oh, good shot. And this one could sail away for the first Platinum Cup sixer of the second innings. Team of Achilles maintaining the dominance. Up in the air and in no man's land, they get that single. Sunny on strike. Last ball of this over. Played it smart there, Sunny. And that is the end of the second over. After the end of 2 overs, the score is 22-2. So 42 required from 36. The story of this match on your screens right now. This is really important for Team of Achilles to win this match. The Bombay Blasters, on the other hand, have 10 points on the scoreboard, just like the 3 other teams that are in the top 4 position. The UA Strikers and the Mumbai Game Changers are on 10 points as well, along with the Bombay Blasters. And yes, finally that catch coming in. And Vedant is the man of the hour. Darshan departs after hitting one good sixer. And that is the third wicket coming in for Team Bombay Blasters. Yes, replay on that catch. Good stuff there by Vedant. Well placed deep in the field. Crucial singles coming in. These singles will prove to be dangerous later on. Farhan Khan on strike. Oh, that's a big one. That's absolutely beautiful. What a hit there by Sunny. High and handsome, the second one of the innings. And great hit there by Sunny. That's a platinum cop sixer. Up in the air again and in the hands of the fielder this time. The Bombay Blasters are trying to pump back some confidence into the veins of their fielders. Some enthusiastic encouragement on the ground after that catch. Can the Blasters make a comeback? Now it's time for the fourth over of the match, the Global T20 Double Trouble Over. Here it is, the Global T20 Canada Double Trouble Over. If there are any prospects of making a comeback into this match, this is the time. Oh, it's a no ball signaled by the umpire and the first ball itself. A wicket here could be -5. Tanuj Virwani, who's in the attack right now from the Bombay Blasters. Every single run is going to prick the Bombay Blasters. They are going to be doubled. Tanuj is doing a good job here. A wicket in this over could be the perfect cherry on the top. Beautiful delivery there by Tanuj. Farhan Khan absolutely bamboozled by Tanuj's skills. A single boundary or a sixer could put this game to bed. Can Tanuj get a wicket? Up in the air, and yes! That is exactly what Team of Achilles needed over here. A platinum cup sixer in the Global T20 Canada Double Trouble Over. 12 runs added to the scoreboard. 46 for 4. Oh, it's a no ball again, signaled by one of the umpires. Score moves up to 48 for 4 and now 50. So that's 50 up for Achilles. Laksh on strike. Still two more deliveries to go. Up in the air and yes, taken. There was too close for comfort. And yes, that is another sixer. And with that, the score will move up to 64. That means Achilles have won the game.
that's an issue, but okay.
It was a clean sweep. A one-sided affair, rather, by Team of Achilles. Bombay Blasters tried their level best at defending an undefendable target. But the dust settles on this battle between two teams. One of them was in the top four. They still are in the top four. This defeat is going to affect their net run rate. Achilles get those 2 points. And they will find themselves either on the fifth or they will remain on the sixth spot. It's all eyes on Team B, who are on the fifth spot of the tournament with 8 points. They have tied with Team of Achilles. Match number four of today, the last game of day nine here at the Platinum Cop Superstar League, is going to be between Achilles and Team B. That's going to be the showstopper of tonight. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the end of a very, very exciting game here. The one of the last league games at the Superstar League. The Superstar League, our title sponsors, Platinum Cop, powered by Global T20 Canada, time partner Swolo Clock, fitness partner Reset, grooming partner Paul Mitchell, NGO partner I Love Mumbai, snack partner Epigamia, flavored water partner Ocean 18, beverage partner Raw Pressery, outdoor media partner Bright Outdoor Media, hospitality partner Sofitel Hotel, bubble tea partner Dr. Bubbles. Special thanks to Mr. Gaurang Vijay Parikh, our associate sponsors Eva Global, Radio Bar, Bar Stock Exchange, Naman Realty, Estella Barrel Mansion, our DJ partner DJ T, our internet partner 7-Star Cable, our broadcast partner tenniscricket.in, our online gaming partner livepools.com, our wardrobe partner Chick Therapy by K, our skin partner RSB Wellness, our therapy partner Aquacentric Therapy, and this event is managed and executed by Star Connect Entertainment. Join us right back in the second game of the day, the UR Strikers versus the Nivan Royals, a clash of the Titans.
Yes, it's time for the post-match presentation. What a wonderful match we had. We are on the last day of the league stages of the Superstar League. It was Bombay Blasters versus Avakulis. Avakulis had to win this match to stay in the competition. They have done it convincingly. They have defeated a powerful Bombay Blasters by 6 wickets. To give away the man of the match and winner of the match, I have Mohammad Ali, one of the league owners. Thank you, sir, for being here. So first, we'll start with the man of the match, who gets a trophy plus vouchers from Bar Stock Exchange, T-shirt from Life Pools, and voucher worth 40,000 from RSB Wellness for a brilliant over, picking up 2 wickets. It's Abhinav Shukla. Yes, Abhinav. With one hand, yes. What a wonderful catch as well. Yes, the man of the match for a wonderful match. Trophy plus Bar Stock Exchange voucher, T-shirt from Life Pools. Voucher worth 40,000 from RSB Wellness. Lot of goodies to come. Abhinav Shukla, also one of the team owners for Avakulis. Wonderful match. Yes. Abhinav, one quick question. You had to win this match. And what a brilliant performance in the field by your team.
We'll get through the finals.
All right. Thank you so much. They still have another match to go, Avakulis. They'll have to win that in order to get into the playoffs. It's time to give away the Woman of the Match award, who gets a voucher worth 30,000 from RSB Wellness and voucher from Chick Therapy by K, and that's Rishma Rochlani, Woman of the Match from the Bombay Blasters. She gets voucher worth 30,000 from RSB Wellness and voucher from Chick Therapy by K. Rishma Rochlani, the Woman of the Match from the Bombay Blasters. Thank you so much, Rishma. All the very best. Yes, that was the Woman of the Match, the Man of the Match, Abhinav Shukla, Woman of the Match, Rishma Rochlani. Yes, it's time for match number 2 of day 9. And that's UR Strikers versus Nivan Royals. First of all, I'd like to call the coin representative of UR Strikers. UR Strikers skipper. Yes, can I have the skipper of UR Strikers? Yes, UR Strikers, you are at number 3 on the points table with 10 points. Yes, now we are going up. So you've already qualified. So how is the feeling in the UR Strikers camp?
Feeling is amazing, positive as always. We hope to get the best out of this tournament, enjoy ourselves and play good cricket.
Wonderful. All the very best. May call the skipper of Nivan Royals. Skipper, yes, Nikhil. Skipper as well as the owner, Nikhil Mansukhani. Yes, you have qualified, the first team to qualify for Superstar League. How's the feeling?
Feels very good. And we're playing this as a final because we knew that we are going to play against each other last match. But just hope for a nice game. That's about it.
Wonderful. All the very best. Yes, we have Mohammad Ali, one of the league owners for the toss. And who will call? UR Strikers, so the first team to qualify will call. Platinum Corp or Superstar? Platinum Corp is the call, and Platinum Corp it is. So Nivan Royals?
We will bat first.
Nivan Royals have decided to bat first.